Michael, and welcome everybody to this year's OwnCloud conference. My name is Holger Dyroff. I'm one of the managing directors of OwnCloud and chief operating officer. And welcome everybody. And with me here is Klaas Freitag.
Hello, good morning. Welcome to the OwnCloud conference in 2021. My name is Klaas. I am the chief technical officer at OwnCloud and engineering lead, and I'm very glad to be here at the conference.
Yeah, we'll have the honor to do the opening session with you. So we're setting the stage for all the nice things which will happen in the next 2 days. So we're going to talk about the current drivers for OwnCloud. We're going to talk about the state of the offering today and tomorrow. We're going to highlight some of the topics of the OwnCloud conference and give you an overview about the resources for later reference, where you particularly can find information about OwnCloud Infinite Scale. And that's certainly the most exciting thing for me at this conference, that we can reveal the details on that. So to start with, I'm sure quite some of you have followed the results of the German elections yesterday. As it seems at this time, it is not yet clear who will rule exactly. But in regards of the things which are important for us as an IT industry in Germany, in Europe, and even across the world, one thing gets very, very clear. Digitalization will be one of the three top items of any German government which will rule going forward. And the pandemic has shown that there are quite some deficiencies, particularly in Germany, but I also think in many other parts of the world. There is a lot of things which still need to be done around digitalization. But our goal and the goal of a lot of people in the IT industry, particularly in the open source industry, is that this digitalization needs to be done with digital sovereignty in mind. This means that we can't just give our data out, that we should stay in control, that we need some level of privacy and all of those things. So I'd like to start with showing you some principles of digital sovereignty as we see it as OwnCloud and as I see it personally. Digitalization must happen in open source. With the Corona Warn app here in Germany, we have seen one of the largest open source government-funded projects being quite successful. And we continue to think that open source is of importance, that it's the headline of digital sovereignty, and that open source offerings are really providing a maximum of security, adaptability, and interoperability. We also think that clouds must be federated. Clouds should be talk with each other, instances should talk with each other, and sharing must be enabled across instances to avoid vendor lock-in and other things. Storage location continues to be important. You must know where your data resides. Is your data in your own data center? Is it at a particular hoster? In which country does it reside? And all of those things, which are part of what's important to make sure that you can adhere to regulations. And digital sovereignty and regulations need to go hand in hand. One of the most important regulations continues to be the GDPR in that regard. Data privacy should be at the design start of really every offering. And there must be a way to separate and really understand where your operator, your service provider, and your user sits and where this data is located. And for some governments, they even say that health data or other data must stay in country, and you must be able to do that. And what do we mean here really in detail with digital sovereignty? It's a prerequisite for independent decisions, either from a state or from an economic perspective. We like to promote profitability, competition, and agility with it, and it's about flexible adoption, further development, and replacement of systems or processes. This must all be possible and transparent to you as a user. and barriers to market shall be lowered. And generally, it's about less dependency on a particular supplier. This is something particularly the German and European governments have looked at it quite in quite some detail. There's a huge initiative, a part of it, which is called Gaia X, which is about to make digital sovereignty happen for all of Europe and to make it usable for all of the world. And a lot of that is really about getting away of the dependencies. A study has shown that there is a really huge dependency, particularly on Microsoft as a vendor, but also on other vendors, be it Chinese, be it American, where there are dependencies which shouldn't be there. We like to be independent, we like to have digital sovereignty, and as of today, there is really no legal basis for US cloud services and to use them. And we like to offer a clear strategy where you can depend your data on with us in the future. However, it's not all about digital sovereignty. Your users need to be able to stay productive. They want to have that carefree productivity they're used to from any other apps they are using, be it on their mobile phone, be it on their desktop or wherever. They like to see this productivity, and that's what we have to have in mind as well. And one thing stays a fact, started by the pandemic, but also before, there are a lot of remote-only companies out there. You will see a lot of the talks here today also happen remotely, even as the two of us are here in our Nuremberg office, but a lot of others are not. And this is where we need to be able to collaborate now and in the future. Remote is here to stay. The pandemic has changed quite a lot of the ideas how people think about the workplace, how people do work together. And it's not just digital nomads and some startups anymore who are really depending on remote work on a daily basis. So with OwnCloud, we like to be the basis of digital sovereignty, remote work, and really be ready for your growing data. OwnCloud evolves into being your data platform. And we like everybody to store data inside, and be it in your data center, be it in our software as a service offering, and access it from anywhere at any time, wherever you're located. We like you to be able to share your data equally if this data sits inside OwnCloud or on any other storage, which you just make universally accessible through OwnCloud, like with the network drive offering we have available. And your users must be able to collaborate and get work done. Collaborate on documents, analyze things in real time. And this is what about 200 million users already do today. And thanks to all our enterprise customers and our large community to make this happen really on a daily basis. With that, Klaas, tell us a little bit about today and tomorrow.
Yeah, thanks, Holger, for this pitch and for this start into the topic. I think it gave a good overview of about what is driving OwnCloud as a project and the company. And I get the honor to take a look into what happened until today and what do we plan in the near future. As many of you know, I joined last November back in this role in the OwnCloud company. I'm very happy to be here and to drive OwnCloud on, especially with our new product OSIS. But let's take a look what happened in the recent past. So many of you know for our product in the market, which is OwnCloud Classic, we released a new version 10.8 beside other minor releases. That was a nice new release solving a lot of problems for customers and users. And also the desktop client 2.9, which brought away better integration with Office apps. When it comes to locking in the virtual file system space, a great improvement with lots of bug fixes and something you should really look into. And we did countless app releases, mobile client releases. I'm very happy to see the agile release culture here at OwnCloud. But even though we did a lot of effort in this product in the market, there was a focus shift towards infinite scale. The development really accelerated. So there is the new web front end OwnCloud Web, which is completely new and comes with a completely new technology base with a focus on usability, with a focus on modern development and on extensibility. It gives us a chance to react on customer wishes and user wishes very quickly because development is easy. Extension is easy. You will see that in talks today and tomorrow, how nice this front-end is, especially when we talk about performance. That is one of the biggest gains here with this front-end. There have been, I think, 13 tech preview releases already with the beginning of 2021, which was a difficult year for us as for anybody else, but we started to release an OSIS tech preview release after every sprint that we finalized. That was a good exercise to get our release pipeline stable, to have regular QA runs, automated QA runs on every release and come up and demonstrate the progress that we make with every sprint end that we have. Why is it called tech preview releases? You know, it's not yet GA. It is usable, but we need to keep the opportunity or the possibility to still have breaking changes in the way how we save data, how we index stuff, how we route through the product. So that's why we are careful and call it tech preview releases. Others might call it already beta versions or whatever. So there are many new interesting concepts in OwnCloud Infinite Scale. As you know, that takes time to come up with them, to think through, to bring in the 10 years experience that we have with OwnCloud and within this area of enterprise file sync and share. Many things are thought through now, are written down, are discussed, and already started to be implemented and coming along nicely. One of the most important and also interesting things is the migration topic. Many customers, many users have all kind of OwnCloud 10 based installations and want to migrate. And that is a very interesting topic. We were thinking a lot about which are the sweet spots for the different kind of installations, for the different sizes of installations, finding ways to migrate seamlessly, which is not easy because if you have a lot of data, you can't just copy over and be happy on a Sunday afternoon because just copying takes longer than the Sunday afternoon would be. So there need to be more interesting and more elaborated concepts for that. And we found them, we documented them, and we already tried them in proof of concept installations. Another thing that is very important to me personally, is the early adopters group and also the community engagement. We founded an early adopter group. Some of the visitors of the conference are probably part of it already. It is a group of people who is already with an serious interest in OSIS, trying on their infrastructure, thinking about how to migrate, how to integrate, and giving us the feedback. It's so-called a professional community working together, helping us understanding the demands, and we share ideas very early. That is a very good experience, and I'm very happy that we have that. And here, thank you everybody who is contributing to this group. So last point here, we grew the team significantly that works on OSIS specifically. Here you see on the slide, you see a picture that we took last week where we had a hack week here in Nuremberg in the headquarter office. It was due to Corona. We thought for it for long, if we can do it here, under which circumstances will it be possible? And finally, we decided to bring in here the OSIS people, not the whole engineering team, unfortunately, but just a few people. And this is the team that you see here. It's even plus two more developers who haven't been here when we took the photo. And it was just great to have everybody here and discuss in person and come up with new ideas and implement and stuff. So that was the past. Now let's take a look into the near future. So where will we go? Of course, there will be product releases also for the OwnCloud Classic products. We will continue to deliver OwnCloud Classic with updates, with security fixes, with bug fixes, of course, but also with smaller feature developments that will move on. We have founded a little team that is exclusively working on OwnCloud 10 topics with very experienced people out of the team that you also know. So this, the ball will keep rolling, but the focus will continue to be on OwnCloud Infinite Scale. So the roadmap is defined now very nicely. You will hear more about in the talk from Patrick Meyer and Jörg Eberwein in a few minutes. I recommend to visit that. It will be very interesting. We will accelerate on roadmap development as we speak. That is our daily business now in this growing team. We will continue to have more tech preview releases for you to see what's going on, to try OSIS, to get engaged maybe. Maybe you want to report a bug, somebody out in the community, get back, go into the discussion with us. Also, this autumn, we will intensify the QA work on the base technology of OSIS. We have big plans of improving the automated QA, of having more tests on OSIS, also for OwnCloud Web, and also for migration scenarios. As I said, that is very important. And we can improve here a lot, and there's a lot to do. And of course, it's very important because we want to deliver high quality. When we come to the GA of OwnCloud Infinite Scale at some point. Later this year, or maybe early next year, there will be the first beta releases. We consider beta as feature complete compared to the minimum viable product definition that product management came up with. Exciting times ahead here for the engineering team. Last but not least, we want to improve again on engaging with the community about OwnCloud Infinite Scale. There's a lot of interesting technology, and it's probably targeting another and a new community as the old OwnCloud Classic technology stack with PHP. So the Go community is a very agile and very very future-oriented community that we are trying to engage with, and have already very nice interactions there with technical people who are interested in what we are building with OSIS for you. Let me get to some topics on this conference. I always like it when people take a little look on the schedule that is ahead in this opening session. Nobody really has time to go through the whole schedule, I guess. I just want to pick out a few highlights, which doesn't mean that the other talks that I don't mention here explicitly aren't interesting enough. Still, we have a lot of talks about the products, especially, of course, about Infinite Scale, starting with this product management talk in a couple of minutes. We have news around the mobile and desktop clients tomorrow morning at Tuesday at 10. And also very interesting, we did big efforts in the accessibility topic for OwnCloud Web. And there will be a very interesting talk today at 11:20, or maybe it's now moving because we started late, unfortunately. There's a track, if you want, so community and partners. Katrin Gieser, our new community manager, will have an announcement today in the morning still. There will be a lot of partner talks today in the afternoon. And there you see what people do with OwnCloud on the base of the OwnCloud file storage, how they do integrations and work with the technology. There's a little science mesh introduction tomorrow made from Jakob from CERN. Yeah, and of course there's a lot of integrations, Office tools, OnlyOffice and Collabora presenting, so this will be very interesting. Technical topics, we have a deep dive tomorrow and this afternoon about OSIS technologies, where we really can go deep. Jörn will present there, and you know how technical he is and how exciting his presentation style is, so make sure to be there. Along with that, there are some workshops about debugging, about setting up OwnCloud Infinite Scale. We thought it's very important to show how easy it is to bring up an OSIS server. And there's another workshop about web extensions, how to integrate with OwnCloud Web. Tomorrow morning, at the end of the day, there will be a panel discussion where we talk about open source in the enterprise, very interesting topic with interesting people joining in from companies and from CERN. So be excited about that tomorrow and make sure to be there. So last but not least, I like to point out a little list of resources because I always see that people do not even know how much we already have available about OwnCloud Infinite Scale. So I assembled a list of useful links that show you what we already did and where you can find information. Of course, it starts with the company website about Infinite Scale. GitHub is for techies, as you know, that we have a web repository for OwnCloud Web and one for Infinite Scale. There you find code, you find all the issues reported. You can interact on a technical level, but please not for support inquiries. There are different resources available for that. We have a very extensible documentation. It's hosted on OwnCloud Dev. I really like to point you to that because it has all the architectural decisions that we made in a so-called ADR format. It's a structured format of documenting technical decisions, why we do things in the way that we do it, and why we have decided so. Very interesting way of documented that. And there are all kinds of how to get started with developments and stuff. Of course, we have a chat if you want to get online in touch with the developers. We have the discussions. And last but not least, very important, there is a demo instance where you can try out OSIS. It's always available on the internet, ready for you to check out the very current state of OSIS all the time. All right. And with that, I am finished here with this little opening. Thank you, Holger, for being with me. And I wish everybody a lot of fun at the conference. Please don't hesitate to give us some feedback, or if you have questions, there are email addresses, or join the chat and just get in touch with us. Thank you very much, and let's have a very nice conference together. And yeah, have fun. Bye.
Thank you. Bye bye.